be here in this beautiful city of Agaer today. And I'm so happy to see the young and beautiful people in your class. They're all wonderful, dynamic, energetic students. I'm sure they will be, as I call them, the pillars of the future. The world of tomorrow is in your hands. You will be all disappearing and you will take over the reins of this world. So I'm very happy to be among the future generation of Hungary. I'll be happy to answer any questions after the presentation. In between as well, as you like, absolutely. So now let us start. I will basically speak on the foreign policy of India, but wherever you feel you want something to connect to according to your choice, according to your thought process, please do let me know. First of all, I'll just give a very brief outline what India looks like. Now, to simplify this, you can compare India with European Union. European Union has, what, 27 members now? I think we have 28 states in India. And you can compare practically European Union in terms of territory. India is more or less similar. In terms of population, of course, we are much larger. It's 1.2 billion people in India now. In terms of geography, it is very different because in the north we have high mountains, Himalaya, which is almost, what you call, 8,800 meters high. Then here we have some desert. You can have a lot of camels and, you know, dunes. Then we have big coastal area here. It's more than 7,000 kilometers of coastal area. We have plains, rivers and plains like Hungary. We have Carpathian Basin. We have Ganges and Brahmaputra Basin. We have Indus Basin. So we have river basins. So this is how the country is. In terms of geographical size, like for example, I come from the state of Rajasthan. Rajasthan is bigger than France in Europe. In terms of area, of course, population, we are always bigger because we have too many people. So this is some idea about how Indian